Here, we're going to talk about everything you need to know when it comes to buying a hummingbird feeder. But be sure to check out my other videos on feeding them, attracting them, babies, and nests. Well, let's get on with this one. Hi, everybody. It's Robbie from Southern California. And today, let's just talk about feeders for hummingbirds, as the hummingbirds are coming back to a lot of areas where they have left for the winter. Now spring is here and they're coming back to look for food and to start nesting. Let's talk about what feeders are the best. And keep in mind, this will really be my opinion because I do have a couple favorites. You can buy a hummingbird feeder for as low as a dollar on up to 100, depending on what you're looking for. And of course, the $100 ones will be specialty ones that are just beautiful, decorative, and really pieces of artwork. But let me tell you something, the hummingbirds don't care about that. I have been feeding hummingbirds now for quite a few years, really not as many as you think. We started with one and now we have thousands. Unbelievable. It seems like all I'm doing is buying new feeders to add to the feeders we have around the property. Real quick, let's touch on the formula. It's very simple. It's a quarter of a cup of white granulated sugar, never powdered. Powder's got cornstarch, and one cup of water. If you can drink your drinking water, they can drink it too. As far as dye, the dye is for you, not as for them. Don't put any dye in. They don't need it. They know what hummingbird feeders are. You can spend as much or as little as you want. But keep in mind, the most common ones, which are really, let's say, under $20, those are the ones they actually know because that's the ones that they're looking for and that's what they see all over the place because, well, people pick them up from the dollar store or nice ones from other stores that cost about $5, $6. They're familiar with those. So if they're flying by and if they look down and if they see them, those are the ones they're going to go for. Now let's talk about the feeders themselves. Generally, they're plastic. You can get glass. Either one is fine. It really doesn't matter. Keep in mind, if a glass one falls, it smashes, it's gone. If a plastic one falls, they usually bounce and you can just clean them up and put them back. So that is up to you. Where to put them? You know, if you've got a shady spot that they can see, then that is best. If you don't have a shady spot, you can put it out in the sun, but you should really change the ones that are in direct hot sun, maybe once a day. You know, the next day, whatever's left, wash it. In the shade, you could go get away with about 3 days without an issue. Mine are in part shade and part sun, but you know, mine are emptied within hours, so we won't even go there. As far as my favorite feeder, the one I like the very best doesn't really have bee guards. The holes are a little bigger, but then the orioles come in and feed from it too. But it's really three pieces, just three pieces, which means it's so easy to clean. Take it apart, clean it out with a toothbrush or a little brush, you know, disinfect it. If whatever you want to use, baking soda and water, a little tiny bleach and water, anything you would clean, dish soap, whatever you would clean your child's dish with. Wash it real good, make sure it's rinsed really, really good, and then you put those three pieces together. And I use a mascara brush to clean the holes if they look dirty. It's that easy to do. Three pieces. Now, there are other ones that are just as nice. They'll have little yellow snap-on flowers, but to keep in mind, those snap-on flowers, they get mold underneath. You'll see if you unsnap them, you know, they really do need to be periodically taken down, cleaned out with a Q-tip or a mascara brush or soaked and disinfected. So though they're nice and I have nothing against them, it's extra cleaning. So keep that in mind, extra cleaning and extra work. And I'm looking for the least amount of work as possible. But they do the job. The ones from the 99-cent stores, dollar stores, they have the three flowers. I twist a little bit of wire around to give them a place to sit because a lot of my hummingbirds here are lazy. They want to come and sit and enjoy their food. Those do the job too. And you can pretty much clean those off with the mascara brush and get those cleaned one, two, three. Now, keep in mind, all the ones that I like, those three I kind of mentioned, they do not have an ant moat on top. So if you've got an ant problem, and usually ants come out a certain time of the year, you can always make your own ant moat. But you'll see that some of them you can buy will have a built-in ant moat. It looks like a little place where you can put water on the top where you're hanging it. They cannot cross water, so the ants cannot get there. If you've got a bee issue, we only have bees once in a while in the late fall when they're going to hibernate the bees or they're looking for that extra food. But if you don't have any bee issue, then you don't have to worry about bee guards. Bee guards are those yellow flowers that are usually on there with tiny, tiny holes. So that's a bee guard. So you have to get what will work for you. But look through them. Look to see how they come apart. See how many parts there are. The more parts, the more cleaning, the more places for mold to harbor and grow. And that is, you know, what you're looking for is what's going to make your life easier and what you want to get, whether you want something beautiful and decorative or just something simple for the hummingbirds to come and feed. And there's a lot of choices out there. You can go to places and stores that have dozens and dozens of types of feeders. So you pick out what will work for you. Think about how many you're feeding. I am feeding quite a few, so I get feeders that have over a dozen seats on them. But if you're only feeding a couple of them in the beginning, you only need a feeder that has like 3 seats, and that will do the job. And then you even have the hummingbird feeders we can make from scratch, from our own house. But we'll get into that another time. So I hope I've given you some information on what you're looking for. Check out the whole thing and see what will work for you. But yes, I do have a favorite. I picked a whole bunch up on eBay. They have a nice size hole. The hummingbird enjoys feeding from it. It's got a beautiful place to sit all the way around. They're really a good price. They're only about $6. And that is basically my favorite feeder, or I should say theirs. With that, have a wonderful, wonderful day. Happy feeding. And don't forget to eat what you grow. And be careful what you wish for, because I started with none and now I have thousands. And my brother told me the other day, he's all excited because he's been feeding one and now there's two out his window. And that's how it all begins. Bye-bye, everybody.